Case two.
Rolling down the street, smoking, sipping on gin and juice.
All right, Snoop Dogg's gin and juice, which is disgusting, by the way. Gin and juice, on the other hand, go really well together.
I personally prefer Rohypnol and juice. What I do is I slip it to myself, I take some swigs, I pass out at a party and hope someone molests me. They never do.
Snoopy!
What?
Why is Snoop Dogg still living at home? He's clearly an adult. Oh, maybe he's Italian.
A lot of gangster rappers try to hide the fact that they live with their parents. Not Snoop. I rapped about my parents' whack-ass yogurt for 5 albums. That's keeping it real. And this goes out to all you hardcore fans of the Home Alone franchise. You guys recognize that scream, right? Also, you're an idiot.
Whoa, Snoop's home alone just like Macaulay Culkin. And just like Macaulay Culkin, Snoop was allegedly molested by Michael Jackson.
What if Snoop was one of the robbers in Home Alone? I really think that if you got hit with the first pink hand, Macaulay Culkin would probably get shot.
Hey, Snoop. Want to mess around?
I'm so high, I can't think straight.
Just the way his eyes likes it.
Riding on your friend's handlebars is better than riding on your friend's handlebar mustache, but just as gay.
Okay, I never thought it was cool to be sitting on the handlebar while somebody is, how do you even see with a big body in front of you and you're trying to steer?
Yeah, so we gon' blow out to this. G's up, freeze up for a second, now bounce to this.
Afros are free, soft, and virtually indestructible. Snoop's been shot in the head 12 times. They don't even look for the bullets anymore.
Okay, Dave. And for all you white people out there, you're probably wondering, what is the use of an afro? One, an afro is there for aerodynamics. Yeah, when we're walking with our stupid limp, the afro keeps us balanced. Two, guys like when girls rub their fingers through their hair too. And as you can see, most black people don't have hair. Except for the afro guys, they live in a different world. And third but not least, hiding stuff. Let's be honest. When was the last time an officer said, I want to check your hair?
This ain't no joke. I had to back up off of it and set my cup down. Tango Reagan, EF toe down now, but it ain't no stop.
Dominoes scare the shit out of me. That's why I don't play them.
How is playing dominoes cool? Like, here they are, like, oh, 8 mother. What other games can they play that they try and make cool? Like, oh, knight to bishop, rook 2.
I'm black, and I have played many a domino games, and I'm letting you know, when you're playing with black people, dominoes is never innocent.
Or, oh, shit, my hungry hippos be eating some pearls.
They slam the dominoes down just to let you know, boom, your turn.
I believe it was Professor Plum in the study with the motherfucking wrench. Sucker. It's like, come on, dominoes?
And Dre got some tricks from the city of Compton to serve me. Not with a cherry on top, cause when I get through, I got to hit the dope spot.
Dr. Dre is the doctor you see when your party is dying. Usually he prescribes like 120 ounces of gin followed by condoms.
Wow, Dr. Dre is like your perverted, dirty uncle who would come to your parties, bring hoes and condoms just so that he could watch. Man, I miss my perverted, dirty uncle.
When my friends come over, they don't bring condoms and hoes. They bring a copy of The Notebook and a cookie log. And we have a good time, damn it.
Imagine if Dr. Dre was actually a doctor. I wouldn't take my kids to go see him. It'd be all like, wanna buy some crack? He try and sell my kids crack. I don't have kids.
I sentence gin and juice to drink itself so it can see how disgusting it is.
I sentence Snoop Dogg's parents to go to IKEA and buy some more furniture. And while you're there, get me a hot dog, a drink, and a cinnamon bun for 50 cents. Yowza.